Well, that's pretty noisy. Last update was essentially a running session, and since then there's been a few things going on, predominantly destruction and replacement rebuilding. And to start off with, the area that I'm using as a footy yard currently has been widened by roughly, well, I'd say 3 inches. As when I was doing a few movements, it was a bit difficult because the wagon was stuck in the tunnel mouth. So that has now been widened short, just by 3. And we go to the main layout, and oh, look at that, new back scene. Yeah, basically the blue back scene, although very nice, with blue logos, it was a bit weird for filming, if you like. So this is the current back scene, which is a brick archway. This is made by Lineside and Locos, which you can search on eBay. And we also had another new product from them, which was basically they call it an oil depot side something. So I ordered one of them as well, and it says it's L gauge, but that sign is seriously overscale. But not to worry. So again, this was mounted on architectural board. It's self-adhesive, and this is how it's come out. And again, the logo there is a bit overscale, but not to worry. What else? Oh, look, building. This is a new build pump house from Railway Laser Lines, and it's done in various scales. You can check them out on their website, and that will be listed somewhere on the page here. We've had a stop sign added for things going in and out of the shed, and we've also had a lot of line side fencing and some woodland scenic green foliage. The fence is from Scale Model Sceneries. It's 50 of scale, so it's not exactly the correct size, but it's good enough. And that's also laser cut, and it's been painted with some Vallejo white grey paint. I do plan to put maybe a level crossing gate there, maybe, or I might actually just leave it blank. Had a bit of damage there. That was my fault. I did fence that off, and it just looked weird, so I basically snapped off the fence. And again, we'll come along here. We've also got the fences right up there. The layer is now named. These were printed for me. eBay. I'll show the link or the company on screen in a moment. Same with the shed in the corner, that's have a label stuck as well. This area here, I'm not too sure what to put in there yet. And in the actual depot area, again, not sure whether to leave that black or maybe put some ballast in there, gravel, something like that. And that's essentially what's been going on. This is a sample of the fence work. There you go. It's you can move it around. It's got a bit of flex to it, and it's, I don't know what it's made up, it's almost like cardboard, but probably not. But this is good stuff. They make some really good products down there in St. Austell. The shunter has now been faded somewhat after some feedback with regards to how I did the previous one. I thought I'd have another go at fading, and this time it's come out correct. Unfortunately, I rubbed off part of the paintwork there by handling the loco, because I don't actually varnish anything. And we come back along here. We've got a stop sign there. Essentially, the loco will come in, stop in the corner there, and just wait for a minute and then pull away into the fiddle yard. And that is essentially what we've been doing. It's not a lot, it's been expensive, but it's slowly coming together, and I need some more figures. The pump house, I must mention that I didn't follow the instructions for building this, hence why there's no windows, because I'd actually glued all the sides and the top and bottom on, and forgetting to actually put the window frame in, which is glued from the inside out. So that will now be as a derelict sort of building. I've still got to put the little pipes. There's a pipe that comes out on the back there, one on the front. But yeah, it's a lovely kit, piece of cake to build. It was just stupid me, didn't follow the instructions, but never mind. So a very short update this month. Still don't know what to do here. I don't know if I can get some figures in there or what. Don't know, but anyway, here we go. The gantry. That was it. That's where the gantry was going to go across there. Well, with that, I've got the fence in place. It can't go there anymore. So, I really like to have one, but it's just, it's expense. It's going to be very expensive now. Wood is not cheap. So maybe a tower in the corner, although it looks a bit stupid there, or maybe put another tower sort of in here to light that bit of that area up. But of course now, because of the level crossing there, it doesn't go to anywhere now. So yeah, not exactly prototypical, is it? A level crossing to a brick wall. But then again, if you looked at it at a perspective, because that's a building there, then technically speaking, I wouldn't have any of the grass there at the back, because the roadway would go across and then go around behind the building. So anyway, here we go. So that's it. Enjoy your model making wherever you are in the world, and let's see what happens in the next 4 weeks. Catch you later. Bye now.